Welcome to Cigar Audit. I'm Matt, and I'm here to review the Romeo and Julieta Exhibition number 4. I recently got a box of these, so I'm pretty excited to try these out. The box code on these is MUL, November 2014. Has a fair amount of age on it, so I'm pretty confident that it'll have a pretty good flavor. So the wrapper on these is a very nice sun-grown Cuban look to the outside of the wrapper. It does have some pretty visible seams, but the veins are minimal, which is nice. It's packed pretty tightly. Almost has a semi-box press to it with your typical Cuban triple cap. This is a Robusto size, 48 by 5 inches, so it should be a fairly quick smoke. Oh, got an explosion. This should have a little bit of spice to it, and a little bit of dried fruit. I've had them before, it's been a long time, so I'm pretty excited. Got a piece of wrapper there. I get a light cedar on the pre-lit draw. A little bit of leather to it. Foot's got a lot of, your standard cedar flavor to it. So let's get it toasted, see what happens here. So today I am without Mr. Ed, but I will be with him on the next review. We will review the Bolivar Bellicosos Finos, and not a Cuava, as he would like to do. Right away, I'm getting a little bit of a earthy, grassy note to it. Not a whole lot of spice. The finish is very bland to start. So let's take a few more, see what happens here. On the retro hail, you get a little bit of hay, earth. Spice is very minimal at this point. At this point, it's an earthy, leathery note. No dried fruit, which I remember having a long time ago, but. So let's see, we'll get a little further into this, get towards the end of the foot third, and we'll be back. Matt with Cigar Audit back here. I'm about half of the way through the foot third, maybe a little bit more. And those seams I talked about, it's interesting, I brought that up in the construction because I do see a little crack. They get a little pop, and so the outside wrapper here, the wrapper is a little bit compromised. I'll take pictures of it so you can see it on the website, but the flavors have transitioned into a musty earth with a little bit of white pepper on the finish. The finish is very short, unfortunately, but a pleasant, very pleasant flavor, very much like an aged tobacco mustiness, similar to what you would get with any older Cuban, but still nice. A little disappointed in that wrapper crack though. Yeah, the white pepper is starting to actually come up a little bit and actually show itself on a draw. So that's a nice surprise, nice little transition. The draw is great. I didn't mention the draw when I first lit, but the draw is perfect. Perfect draw. Burn got off a little bit, but it's fixing itself as we speak. So I'm going to get a little further into this, see what transitions we get, and we'll be back. So here we are into the getting into the body third, still early on, but you can see the ash is holding very well. And the flavor profile has changed quite a bit. The musty earth is still there with a little bit of leather, but it's also gotten a few floral notes and a little bit of dried fruit from here and there, not powerful. And with that pepper, there's a little bit of cinnamon, which is really nice. I bet you this ash is going to fall on me. So far, so good. Construction is pretty good. We had that issue with the wrapper, but the ash is held on fine. It corrected itself. The draw is great. Flavors are good. It's gotten spicier as the cigar has progressed. And not really anything to complain about. It's I wish some of that fruit was a little bit more visible to the palate, but it isn't. It's just a little bit here and there. But at the same time, I will say that what I am tasting is very good and very well balanced. Again, still that mustiness, musty earth, very much like an aged tobacco. This really isn't that old of a cigar. This cigar is a year and 4 months or thereabouts. So for a Cuban, that's not all that old. And it's producing really well, better than I thought. It's a good cigar, but I expected some youth still in this cigar. It's not a high-end Cuban cigar, but nonetheless, it's a well-performing one and a very popular one, too. So anyway, I'll get a little further into the body towards the last third, and I'll check back with you. So I'm back here towards the end of the body third here, and this cigar has outperformed my expectations in that third. The flavor profile is fairly complex for a cheaper Cuban. It's not super cheap, but it's also not your high-end Cuban cigar. The flavor profile has been that musty earth is still there, and you get hints of floral, but I'm getting a black cherry, which is really good. You still get a little saltiness. The finish has a little bit of that white pepper, touch of cinnamon, and occasionally on the finish you get some of that black cherry, which is really interesting. But the flavor profile has done extremely well. Construction has done really well in spite of the wrapper having looser seams. So I don't know whether I should be happy that it's performing so well with looser seams, or be upset that there's looser seams, but at the end of the day, it's performing very well. It's only dropped ash once, so draw is good. Body is medium body throughout. Maybe a little lighter at the beginning, but the body of the cigar is pretty middle of the road. But the flavors are very good. I'd say the flavors are a little bit more than medium, and it makes for a pleasant experience for sure. The retrohale, I get a lot of that white pepper, little cinnamon on the retrohale. Not surprising, it pretty much matches the finish of the cigar. But the burn has been great, pretty much razor sharp. The The draw is good. Everything about the cigar is better than I thought it would be. I thought it would be a good cigar, but it's performing very, very well. The very beginning was tasted like a young cigar with a little bit of hay, but as soon as that mustiness kicked in after about four or five draws, that musty earth, it really became a great cigar. I have no complaints except for the wrapper issue, which hasn't really caused a problem at all. And it's that musty earth again. Very, very nice Cuban-esque flavor, aroma. Everything about it is really enjoyable. And maybe it's more enjoyable because Ed's not sitting next to me. I don't know. We'll find out tomorrow because he's doing a couple of reviews with me tomorrow. So we'll see how that goes. And there comes that black cherry coming in there on the draw. In the finish, you get that cinnamon pepper, which is nice. Very nice. A little salty at times, but... just have a drink with you, and you're good to go. So, not bad for a almost 1 o'clock in the morning smoke. So, I'm enjoying it greatly. I'll get down into the last third here, and we'll get back at it. Matt from Cigar Audit, back here at the end of this RNJ Exhibition number 4. And the last third was very similar to the body, very good. The cherry kind of stepped back, went back to the musty earth a little bit more, but finishes basically the same, with that white pepper, a little bit of cinnamon. The draw is still good, construction's still good. Everything about the cigar is really good and enjoyable. I really don't want it to end, so I might burn my fingers here at the end. As you can see, lots of smoke. And the smoke smells good. It smells like an aged Cuban tobacco. Very, very well constructed cigar, even with those loose seams, which... I guess it bugs me on principle more than anything because it's performed really well. So I'm going to go ahead and rate this cigar. It's been a great time with it. I'm going to say on the look and feel, it's pretty good. The seams do bother me. Construction overall is pretty good. The flavors are outstanding. In general, the value is really good. You know, for this level of cigar, to get this type of experience, even though it's a Cuban cigar, it's pretty impressive. So I'm going to go ahead and rate this higher than I thought I would. I'm going to rate this at a 94. This was a very good cigar. Really, the only thing that I could say bad about it was it started a little slow. And flavor profile, and the seams were a little loose. This particular cigar performed very well, regardless of those issues. Other cigars in that same box may not be as high producing. So we'll see. But I'm rating this cigar, and I'm going to say 94. I'm really excited about it. Hopefully they're all this good. Especially a buddy of mine, Rich, who's going to have some himself. So hopefully he gets the same experience. Otherwise, I have a lot of explaining to do. So, but anyway, thank you for joining me on Cigar Audit's RNJ Exhibition number 4. And don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel. Give us a thumbs up if you could. Check us out on Facebook. And don't forget to check out cigaraudit.com. Where we have a lot of reviews that are not video reviews. We do the old-fashioned text reviews with pictures. So check us out there, and smoke them if you got them. Thank you very much for joining us, and we'll see you next time.